Welcome back to another Project Rebirth review. The Shazam movie comes out this week, so I thought no better time to review this $10 basic fig. Here's a look at the front of the box. And taking a look at the front of the box, we can see the figure itself displayed in clear plastic, and on the lower left-hand side, we can see the single accessory, the figure Wrath. And here's a look at the back of the box. It shows the figure again itself, and also the other figures available in this series. And then here's Wrath, and they're referring to it as a power slinger, and almost, you know, you use it like a slingshot, and you pull on it, and then the figure goes flying. All right, let's get Shazam out of the box. All right, here's Shazam out of the box. Let's take a close-up look at his face. So I think this isn't bad. I think it does look a fair amount like Zachary Levi, the actor that plays Shazam. And it is very similar to the face sculpt on the $20 multiverse figure. Taking a look at Wrath, you can see that you're meant to put your hand through here and pull it back and let it fly. Now let's see that in slow-mo. Here's an up-close look at Wrath. Let's take a 360 look at Shazam. Taking a look at articulation, figure's head can move from the left and to the right, but not all the way around because of the cape. Arms can extend at the shoulders to 90 degrees, bend at the elbows to 90 degrees, wrists rotate, and should flex in slightly, although really not much movement here. Figure can turn at the waist. Oh man, that leg's not going anywhere. Oh, there we go. Okay. Legs can extend to 90 degrees and bend to 90 degrees. And then the boots can swivel from side to side at the upper calf, and a solid piece boot. So all in all, decent articulation for a $10 basic fig. This figure measures almost exactly 6 inches tall. Let's take a look at Shazam along with some other figures. Here is Shazam along with the Justice League from the far left, the Aquaman from the Aquaman movie, and then the Justice League multiverse figures of Superman, Batman, Flash, and Wonder Woman. So here you can see this $10 fig looks a little bit short in stature compared to the other figures, especially compared to the Jason Momoa figure on the far left, but it doesn't look bad. Here is Shazam alongside Superman, and alongside a basic Wonder Woman figure from Batman vs. Superman, and alongside the interactive Aquaman on the right-hand side. All right, so here's my final thoughts with regard to this Shazam basic figure. Really, I think what it's going to come down to is which one do you want, the basic figure or the $20 figure. I'm going to pause the video now so you can take a look at each. So as you can see, the basic figure and the $20 multiverse figure have nearly the same head sculpt, and everything looks very, very similar. Just everything's a little bit nicer with the $20 figure, and you get some extra hands. So the question is it worth paying twice the price to get one that matches your other figures if you have multiverse line, and to get those extra features and finer details? For me, this figure was fine just as it is. And the other benefit of the $10 line, besides the cheaper price, is you can collect the entire Shazam family. And right now, that's not a possibility with the $20 multiverse figures. I'm not sure if I'm going to pick up any other ones. I might pick up Freddy, but that'd be about it. But it's nice to have that option. Another thought I had, too, you've often heard me complain in videos about stupid accessories. And I got to say, this one's a lot of fun. I think definitely little kids would have fun playing with this and shooting it at their brothers and sisters and that kind of thing. And, some toy reviewers might have fun with it too. But all kidding aside, if you don't want to spend $20 for the multiverse figure, should you buy this $10 basic figure? Hell yes. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next Project Rebirth review.